Today on Make and Drink, we're going to be making the Vesper, which is the cocktail from James Bond. Now, James Bond was first introduced to us in 1953 by author Ian Fleming with Casino Royale. And in this book, we get the first James Bond cocktail, which is the Vesper. Now, most of you are probably like me and you're familiar with the movies. And up until 2006, we only really thought of James Bond as drinking a martini, which was, of course, shaken and not stirred. But that all changed in 2006 in Daniel Craig's first movie, Casino Royale, which was based on the 1953 story of the same name. While the Vesper Martini was known by the diehard Bond book fans before 2006, Daniel Craig's version is what popularized it by today's standards. In the book, the recipe is written as an order from James Bond, where he says for 3 measures of Gordon's, 1 of vodka, 1/2 a measure of Kina Lillet, shake it very well until it's ice cold, then add a large thin slice of lemon peel. In the 2006 movie, we hear the order as
3 measures of Gordon's, 1 of vodka, 1/2 a measure of Kina Lillet, shake it over ice, and then add a thin slice of lemon peel.
From what we believe, Ian Fleming did not actually create this drink, but it's believed that it was his friend, Ivar Bryce, who created this recipe. Now, Bryce was an interesting character as well, and he was from a well-off family who made their fortune selling guano.
That sounds so familiar. Bat droppings. Yummy!
And he actually helped Fleming locate a piece of land in Jamaica, where Fleming would then go on to build his home, which he named Goldeneye, and he went on to write every single Bond book from this house in Jamaica. Now we know the recipe and its history, but yet I'm not going to make that drink, and there are 2 specific reasons why. First of all, I don't like this recipe. I don't like the proportions. It has way too much booze. It calls for 4 ounces of gin and vodka, and that's just way too much in any sort of martini. This is a perfect example of a drink that is just going to die in the glass. There's no way this drink is going to stay chilled long enough to enjoy. So you're probably just going to be drinking some warm gin and vodka. The second reason why I'm not going to make that drink today is because you can't. Kina Lillet stopped being produced in 1986 when the appetites for bitter drinks fell out of favor. Now, since that time, and definitely since 2006, the most common recipe we've seen is for using Lillet Blanc. And while it's made by the same company as Kina Lillet, they are 2 totally separate ingredients. Now, Kina Lillet used bark from a tree in Peru, and in fact, the name Kina is derived from the use of that tree called the Kina Kina tree. But nowadays, we just know this as cinchona bark, and that's what goes into making the quinine that you're familiar with in drinks like a gin and tonic. Now, today, if you want to make this drink, you need to sub out the Kina Lillet for something else. And most common, you'll see recipes call for Cocchi Americano. Cocchi Americano is an aromatized wine that has quinine, and it's believed to be the closest match to Kina Lillet. Another option for you would be Kina Liero Dior, which is from Tempus Fugit, and it's another Kina that has a similar profile to what Kina Lillet would have had. So let's just go ahead quickly and taste all 3 of these. First, the Lillet Blanc. Lillet Blanc is delicious. It goes well in many drinks, including martinis, but it doesn't have that quinine bitter flavor. It is sweet. It tastes like a sweetened white wine. This doesn't work in a real Vesper. So let's taste the Cocchi Americano. You get that quinine bitter. It is a different type of bitter than like a vegetal or earthy bitter. It tastes more in line with the quinine you're used to in a gin and tonic. All right, the Kina Liera Dior from Tempus Fugit. I know a lot of people say Cocchi Americano and Tempus Fugit, Kina Liera Dior. They're very similar. I don't really catch a similarity. Kina Liero is not as bitter as Cocchi, but it is earthier. Kind of reminds me of like a first step toward a Suze. It has that earthy, vegetal, gentian root flavor. And I think you can use that in a Vesper, but we're not going to today. Also, just a side note about all of these drinks, as well as your vermouths. You may know this, but you should be storing your vermouths and your aromatized wines in your refrigerator and not out on a countertop. Now, many of these aromatized wines, they'll tell you to keep them for 2 weeks. I keep them much longer. I've had this bottle of Cocchi opened in my refrigerator for months, and to me, it tastes just as good as the day that I opened it. Now, because I don't like the original recipe because it's way too boozy, I'm also just gonna modify this drink to be 2 parts gin, to one part of our aromatized wine, in this case, Cocchi Americano. So let's get to making this Vesper Martini, and you don't need to stir these because, like James Bond, we're gonna serve these shaken and not stirred. I'm gonna start with 1 ounce of Cocchi Americano, 2 ounces of Tanqueray gin, shake it for 10 to 15 seconds. I just want to take a little bit to express into the drink. We're going to garnish this with a long lemon twist. There you go, the Vesper Martini.
You know, that's a hard bad. I'm going to have to think of a name for that.
If you haven't had one of these, I say try it. Get yourself a bottle of Cocchi Americano. You can use it in a bunch of different drinks. It's bitter, it's refreshing, it's extremely cold because we're shaking this drink instead of just stirring it. And it's just a much more sophisticated martini. Technically, it's not James Bond's martini, but it is in spirit. So can we make another Vesper style martini using different ingredients and a different technique, but still trying to get that gin and quinine flavor into a martini? But the idea I had for this one, which I have not tried, is to use a tonic syrup. Now, my favorite tonic syrup from Jack Rudy Cocktail Company. I'll do 1/2 ounce of Jack Rudy. 1/2 ounce of Lillet Blanc. And 2 ounces of gin. All right, we're gonna shake this for 10 to 15 seconds. Same thing with this one, we'll express one into the glass. And let's give this thing a taste. It's definitely, it's not the same. It's not as bitter. I think if you up the Jack Rudy, you're not gonna get more of that bitterness because you're gonna be putting too much sugar into it. So I think it makes a pretty tasty cocktail, but it's not a good substitute for the Cocchi Americano. It's kind of failed at that one, but this is still a good drink. And if you don't have Cocchi, if you don't have Kina Leo Dior, you don't have another option to substitute for Kina Lele, I think using some type of tonic that you already have, like a tonic syrup, and something else, like you have a Lillet Blanc or another, even just like a white wine in 1/2 ounce, I think that would make a really tasty, delicious drink that is in the spirit of the Vesper. That's it for this one. That's it for the Vesper Martini from James Bond. This is a delicious martini. It is, I'll just say it, it's my favorite martini. And I think the one with Cocchi Americano is great. Really, if you're into bitter, if you're into quinine, try Cocchi Americano. Give it a shot. Don't have to throw it away after 2 weeks. Keep it for months. Pay attention to the flavor if it changes over time. But it's a great addition, a great staple to any bar. And if you've tried this recipe, let me know in the comments below. If you've done it with just Lillet Blanc, let me know as well. And otherwise, if you enjoyed the video, like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And we will see you on the next one.